actually read about it in the newspaper yesterday, is the fact that people who do donate, most of the wealth is going to the sexy places. And it's around the center of Israel. They don't really branch out.
The truth of the matter is a lot of people, when they donate money, they actually are donating to get their names out there. They want to be recognized. You take the hospitals. It's the big hospitals in Tel Aviv and around Tel Aviv that are getting money. You see these big, beautiful buildings that they're putting up. But when you go to the periphery, it's not there. You look at Sfat, that actually it's doing a tremendous job for the Syrian refugees and for the people in the north. It's a very poor hospital. It's not something, it's not sexy. It's too far. People don't know about it. They don't see. It's a shame. It really is a shame.
So you're saying that we can go visit Sfat next week?
I say what?
We can go visit the Sfat hospital next week.
Absolutely.
Okay. What is the project that you are involved in now? I have two more things and we're done.
Time's almost. Time's really up, but I'd like to tell you. Yeah. The last thing that one of the things that I'm involved in that I'd like to just tell you about is actually Space IL. I got involved in the concept of, in the idea of putting up an unmanned spacecraft on the moon. This is part of a Google prize. I think the prize was $20 million. I got involved in it right from the beginning, and I've been involved with it right up to now. And we're actually planning to launch this spacecraft in February. The SpaceX of Elon Musk is actually taking us into space, and then we will go around the Earth, and then we will go around the Moon and the Earth until we've got the Moon in the right position, and then we will land. And people ask me, why did you do this? I mean, it's a little bit of a crazy project if you think about it. But actually, there are three countries in the world that have put a spacecraft on the Moon. It's Russia, China, and the United States. And I think if Israel, little Israel, can put it up as well, and it'll be the four of us, I think that will give us a tremendous sense of pride. And I think for young people, we're exciting them about space, we're exciting them about science, we're exciting them about engineering. And I think that this will do for Israel what the Apollo project did for the United States. And then another thing we're doing, we're putting Israel aircraft industry into space. And this, I think, space is the next frontier. And I think that this contribution that we're making to the technology that we're developing, this gives me a sense of satisfaction. But I must tell you, it started off as an $8 million project and is now $100 million. And Google has canceled the prize because we didn't get it in time. But I've personally underwritten this project. I want to see it through. And I feel if we spent as much as we have to stop in the middle would have been a crime. And I think to achieve the objective will really be something great. I think it'll give us all a sense of pride. It'll really give us a sense of pride.
Do we have time for one more? Okay, so I have to tell you that since we've been writing your book and traveling, meeting the Pope, people hosting us in their beautiful homes, hotels, the happiest I've seen you is when we go to Ethiopia for the eye camp and we sleep in tents on the floor. It's hot, there's bugs all over, but you wake up in the morning and you are happy throughout the day and you are centered, and it's the happiest I've seen you. How do you explain that?
I'd just like to tell you that actually when I turned 80, I met somebody who told me that for cataracts, it's an operation which you can do in about 25 minutes. And in Ethiopia, because of the climate, because of the sun, because of hygiene, because of diet, these people suffer from cataracts and trachoma. They're basically blind, and they've been led around by an another person. And I felt if you can do an operation in 25 minutes and give somebody sight, this it's not only a good thing to do, I think it's a crime not to do it. So I gave myself a birthday present, and I took a group of ophthalmic surgeons and volunteers to Ethiopia, to a little place called Jinka, which is in the middle of nowhere. These are the poorest people that I've seen in my life. And we did 600 operations in the first camp. And I tell you, when you can actually give somebody sight, and they come to you blind and led, and you can give them sight, and they walk away on their own, you've done something. And it gives one a tremendous sense of personal satisfaction. It's satisfaction that money can't buy. You've got to really get into it and do it. And I've been doing it every year since then. And we live under difficult conditions in Ethiopia. And actually, we had children who've come to us who've been born blind, who've never seen. And we do a simple operation. And this little child the following day walks. I can't describe to you the exhilaration of doing something like that. And this is something that, for me, I don't know if I can convey to you the joy of doing something good and feeling good about it. It does something good for your soul. It really does. It's better than another house or a bigger car or another holiday. It really does something for your soul. I don't suggest that all of you go to Ethiopia. But actually, there are things that you can do. Think about it. Just think about it, the things that you can do that already improve the quality of your lives, not only of theirs. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
That was quite a note to end on. I think nobody could have said it better. I hope you've all found a little bit of inspiration, some ideas for your own life. I think those last few sentences might have said it all. And please join us right outside for dinner and drinks, some networking, a chance to maybe get any questions that you still have left over answered. Thank you so much for being here.